here, and I'm gonna read it in a little bit of a soft spoken voice, okay? Like whispered and soft spoken. So basically, I see a lot of creatures. I found a lot of creature videos, or not videos, stories. And that is what I want to read about is creatures today. Because I think that would be pretty interesting for Halloween. We're all going to be dressed up as scary things, pretty things, and things that we wonder if they exist. Okay? So, this one's called The Moth. You will never believe what I saw one cold and dry November night. My family and I moved into a new house on a hill, on a little back road in the very small town of Fort Gay, West Virginia. Fort Gay sits right on the east side of Kentucky. The population of
take a trip.
strange thing about it was its mouth, which never seemed to be closed. And where you would expect teeth were tooth-shaped fleshy protrusions. No one, not even the creature, seemed to be scared. And after a while, it lazily slithered back into the ocean. There were roughly 10 witnesses to this thing, and we all spent most of our time talking about what it must have been. Our idea that it was a parasite organism for a much larger creature. One also possibly never identified. Okay, so this one is called the Prime Hook Swamp Creature. I was driving on Broadway Killen Road in Broadbrook Kill Beach, Delaware, around dusk in July 2007. The road borders a swamp area. Standing on the side of the road by a swamp, my daughter and I saw a creature like we've never seen before. It stood about 2.5 to 3 feet tall, with long legs, a tan body, a flat, almost puckish face, and a long tail. It had small ears and looked about 30 pounds. My other daughter and her friend also saw the same animal the year before, around the same area, except it was night and it ran in front of their car. I asked the lady who owned the Broadkill Beach store about it, and she said she had seen it once when she was dirt biking with her dad in that area years before, and both her and her dad had made work easy. The dearth of milk denied us any actual labor, but management wouldn't let us not come to work, so we would show up and mess around all shift. I was working nights at the time. It was 2 or 3 a.m., and I was out on the loading dock watching bats fly around the floodlights because I liked being out in the cool night air. The corn was about as high as my shoulders, so about 5 to 10. As I was watching the bats, I looked down at the edge of the cornfield. Something was moving there. It was the size of a small child and very skinny, pale, with something that looked like a head of straight black hair. It moved in a sort of jerky gait, like someone dancing the robot badly. It moved in chunks, legs, then hips, then torso, shoulders, neck, and finally head. Okay, that creeps me out. It was looking back into the cornfield, or at least I felt like it was. I felt prickly all over. I didn't know what it was. I thought it was a heroin addict or something, but it looked too much like a person. A heron. Or something at first, but it looked too much like a person. It didn't move like a person, though. Gradually, step by step, it moved toward me, letting my curiosity better my fear. I moved toward the edge of the dock, which was raised a few feet off the ground. When I got within a few feet of the edge, the thing looked at me. I was paralyzed. I could have run, but I was stuck somewhere before and terrified and intrigued. It moved, its face still pointed at me. It ratcheted its body in that disconcerting way, jerking movement toward the cornfield, and went into it. I tried to watch where the field went, moved as it passed, but the corn remained perfectly still. Noticed that all the crickets were silent. After a few minutes, nothing happened. I stood out there for an hour, but it never came back. I never saw it again. That is creepy. I wouldn't want to see something walking like that. It kind of reminds me of, like, The Exorcist or The Grudge or something like that. The next one is a grindleo. Grindy low almost dragged them into a pond. I don't know what a grindy low is. I guess we'll find out. I was almost taken by a grindy low when I was about 5 or 6. We went to a park near our house that had a pond. I was fascinated with the small creatures, waters, bugs, fish, algae, everything. So I was squatting down staring at this incredible little universe when completely enchanted with it all. Suddenly something green came out of the water, grabbed my little shoe, and pulled it. It happened in an instant. My foot slid forward into the water, and I fell backwards onto my butt. It was in the water with a tiny splash, as fast as lightning. I blinked, then got up and ran to my mom, saying something grabbed my foot and tried to pull me in the water. My mother tried to console me, saying my foot simply slipped on the muck, but I know the truth. Okay, this one is called Their Husband Saw a Group of Tiny Creatures in Morph Suits. When my husband was a child, he used to see what he called little men in his house. He saw them a few times, about 8 years old to maybe 12. He would only see them at night and only in his basement, never outside or in anyone else's home. He describes them as being about 7 or 8 inches tall, and they were each one solid color, as if they were wearing morph suits. No one saw reds. He saw red ones, green ones, and cream colored ones. No facial features, no hair. He said they really looked like people in morph suits. They were completely silent, no sound, while two small red people run into the bathroom. That's when my husband got scared and told his friend how he was hoping it was only in his imagination and explained everything to him. The two of them saw them a few more times until they just weren't there anymore a few years later. My husband thinks they were either collecting something or looking for something. They seemed very exploratory in nature. Nothing was ever missing that he noticed. He was a kid, so he hadn't been drinking or anything like that at all. My husband absolutely does not lie. His friend sadly passed, so I can't ask him about the little men, and no one else saw them. That's kind of weird. It reminds me of something when I was a kid, but it wasn't the same. It's a weird thing. Okay, so this one's kind of scares me too. The shadow people. They were visited by the shadow people. This happened when I was really young. I was around 6 to 9 years old. A little backstory. I had a significant trauma happen to me when I was 6. I don't want to go into details, but it made life difficult for a while. I totally shut down for a bit, and sleep at the time was my only safe haven. For the next couple of years after my incident, my dreams got stranger and stranger. At first, only saw them in the background of my dreams, like part of the scenery almost. Then I began to lucid dream. All of a sudden, those dark shadow people with red eyes began to manifest in my room. I never felt danger from them, and that gave me a sense of relief. I would talk to them like they were someone I knew, and I would tell them about my day. A lot of times these conversations would end because they would hear something and move off my bed. I would wake from my semi-sleep state by trying to go after them. Towards the end of my encounters with these creatures, I got a sense of terror, and I could never pinpoint it until one night. A white figure came through my door and reached out with a knife toward me. I woke up with a jolt and never saw any of them again, though I will sometimes see one of them dart out of my vision. That's creepy. So dark shadow people and a white figure.
Unloaded, so I stopped and started loading it. I only brought 20 rounds with me
was left of a past. It was almost that, like it was placed there for me to find. The only thing was, it looked like it had been dead maybe a day at most. And what was I smelling seemed like it was far more decomposed. This obviously didn't sit well with me, so I double-timed it on the magazine loading. I guess I should have taken the opossum as a last chance to turn around. I was almost to the field when I saw it. I was at the end of the creek, and the feeling of the being watched was unbearable. Just as I was near the end of the creek and at the edge of the woods, I heard a splash in the water. Walking down the creek away from me was something I will never forget. At least 8 feet tall, probably taller, very skinny. Imagine a grown man that weighs 120 pounds. Now stretch him out to be 8 feet tall, but his body width says the same. Very long arms, and it walked on two legs, skin stretched tightly around its body. It made no noise, aside from the splash when it stepped in the creek. While it walked, it also had a very weird walk, almost like a waddle, but taking large steps. But that could have been because it was on a muddy creek bank. It was also a light brown color, almost like that of a deer. I pressed the bolt release to chamber a round in just in case the monstrous thing decides to attack. I did not intend on striking first. The round gets stuck somehow and doesn't even budge out of the magazine. I had never used that magazine before, so it didn't fail from if use. My only guess is that the thing had something to do with it. The magazine never worked right again, and I had to return it. The thing books it out of there without running or making a noise. I had long enough exposure to get the details I provided about it. That is creepy, because like I had some weird feelings in Kentucky where I lived. It was a really old place, like there had been civil war that had gone on there. And we had a creek on the property. And it was pretty creepy. I had kept on getting this weird feeling, and I kept on, I don't know, I had some weird dreams, like really night terror type dreams when I was down there. I also did other places, but this was a little bit different. And my little nephew, when I brought him to Kentucky, he said, "Auntie, this is creepier." So I liked Kentucky, but Kentucky is creepy, no offense to anyone from there, because I liked it, but it was creepy. Okay guys, so I'm debating on whether I should read more. Yeah, let's read it. They saw a golem-like creature at their friend's house. This is something that happened to me about 2 years ago at my friend's house. She lived right across a fairly busy two-lane road from the parking lot on our college campus. The other 5 people in the house were asleep, and it was about 3:30 in the morning. I went outside to smoke a cigarette because I couldn't sleep. I'm sitting on the front swing, and I hear rustling. I figured it was literally any type of animal and ignored it. But then I heard what sounded like something on two legs shuffle through the leaves on the sidewalk at a very fast pace. Now I'm alert. I stand up, still smoking my cigarette, and then look over on the right side of the property with tiny evergreen-esque bushes. The sound trailed from the left to the right of the property. Now the parking lot is across the street. The tall lights are on at all hours, so it illuminates from behind, leaving me to only see silhouettes. I see something that may have been about 4 feet tall. that it might be a little person, but I know yet for a fact it was not. This thing was very thin and perfectly proportioned, like a thin, sickly child. I guess it kind of looked like that guy from the Lord of the Rings movies. I looked down at my cigarette for no more than a second, and when I looked back up, it was gone. I heard movement, and I said, fuck this, and ran inside, locked the door behind me. Then, sitting on the couch, I was staring at the window when I suddenly saw something run across, blocking a portion of the light from parking lot as it went by. For it to do this, it had to have been on the porch where I just stood.